This is my refrigerator. Sparkling water, beer, spicy pickles, artichoke, hummus, baby carrots, grapes, bread. You get the idea.
This is not my fridge. This is a town fridge.
Had you ever heard of a town fridge before?
I have not.
The 200 or so people of you that listen to Boosie and I talk to each other on Tell's podcast may have heard of us discussing this town fridge project before.
Refrigerators that you can go and donate food, water. It's available for anyone. So whether you lost your job, just don't have enough food, you can go to this town fridge and grab what you need, or you can help replenish the fridge.
This refrigerator here is for everybody. The motto, leave what you can, take what you need. Or maybe the other way around. Take what you need, leave what you can.
Try my phone number. Much better. I'm gonna deny that I have a little bit of a bug. PLOitis of the multi-table variety. It can be a little tough to focus on one single table of live poker after multi-tabling Pot Limit Omaha and sometimes playing heads up Pot Limit Omaha online, but I'm trying my best. Here's a hand of Pot Limit Omaha that I played and lost. Here's another hand that I played and lost. Here's yet another hand that I played and lost. And here's a hand that I won. So, yeah, most of these hands definitely playable. Sometimes approaching impatience, but hanging in there. Trying to shoot a segment for your vlog where you talk about some poker hands, I recommend the roof of any parking garage. Just look at that. Look at that scenery back there. Well, your boy was in the mix. He was firing and he was gambling in that Pot Limit Omaha. Sometimes he cannot help himself. Exhibit A. Action pulls to the button, who makes it $15 to go, which is the maximum raise in this 1-2 game because it's $5 bring-in, so we just pretend it's $5 big blind. Maximum raise of $15 from the button. I look down at Jack 10 9 8 with one suit. The perfect rundown, Jack high. Anyway, I make the call and the big blind puts in a 3-bet. Makes it $60 to go and the button is pretty short stacked. He's only got like $155 or something like that. He jams it in there. He can have basically anything. It seems like he's stuck city and not really in the mood to play any actual poker, sticks it in there, $155. The problem is, we're caught in the middle here, and the action is gonna get reopened. If I flat call here, the big blind is gonna stick it in there a lot of the time. It's Jack 10, 9, 8 though, you know? It's Jack 10, 9, 8. Four cards all in a row. There's a suit in there. Yeah, who likes folding? Who really likes folding? Anyway, we came to ride the PLO waves, so let's ride them. I call the 4-bet jam, but sure enough, the big blind sticks the rest of the money in there. It's like somewhere between $4 and $450, I think. Can't fold at this point, of course. So we're off to the races. The big blind asks if we want to run it once or twice. I don't say anything, but the button says he would prefer one time. And that one time is not helpful to the Jack 10, 9, 8. So this perfect rundown is perfectly useless, and we get scooped by the pocket aces of the big blind. So down, we were down off the bat, then we were up, I think somewhere around $400, and then all the way back down to minus a couple hundo or something after this hand. But the action does not quit. The action doesn't stop there. And when I say action, I mean me providing the action. So in this next hand, the under the gun player raises it up to 15. We looked down at 9987, double suited. I don't think it's too good of a play to flat call here because we invite a lot of players into the hand where it's unlikely that we're gonna be dominating anybody. It's more likely that the reverse would be true. So I decided to put in a 3-bet here with a hand that can do okay post-flop. I raised it up to $50 and it folds around to the small blind who puts in a 4-bet this time, all the way up to $170. The under the gun player gets out of the way. Not ideal, but we have two suits. We have a pair, which is good news, bad news. I'm not gonna go too in depth into analyzing a PLO hand. So anyway, I decide to make the call because it's gonna be pretty straightforward since we're not super deep. The flop comes down king, queen, 10 with a flush draw, which we do have, but it's a little unfortunate because that's pretty much all we have going for us in this hand. It's pretty obvious, it's pretty clear that we are up against pocket aces. Not the best, most ideal situation, but it's only gonna be like $350 at this point. So you just go ahead and stick it in there. And with a flush draw, sure, we can knit it up and just fold since we only have a 9-high flush draw working for us in this hand, which could be dominated, but again, hey, nobody likes a knit. So anyway, we're gonna call this off. We're off to the races. We have ourselves a flush draw. We're gonna have some equity a lot of the time, I think. I'm guessing, I have no idea. Anyway, the turn is queen, pairs the board, and the river is the four of hearts. So we make a flush, and my opponent shows down dry aces. So what do you know? Hey, we win a pot. Play bad, get there, ride the waves, try and sneak out with the win, which is what we do. Get into the game for $800, and we get out of the game for 1,040-ish, something like that. We win $240, which is enough to cover the groceries and a little bit of profit.